Okay, so out here at another location, this is the third painting for today. This spot is a mile away from where I previously was, and you can hear how huge the difference is with the wind. Anyway, this is the view I'm going to be painting. I'm going to talk a little bit through this one, you know, so feel free to listen, but if the sound and the wind is too much, feel free to mute this and play something, some music on something else while you just, if you just want to watch. Anywho, so I'll be using the Ron Ransom palette, Ron Ransom ink. I've added phthalo blue to this. And if I wind up using that, I'll talk about it. But that's kind of the only change I really make to that palette. Anyway, so with this scene, the last one I painted, I had a very low horizon line, and I thoroughly enjoyed that. So I really just work on painting the sky. So I'm going to have a low horizon line. I kind of have to make the decision if I want to leave white space for the houses, or if I want to scrape out the houses. But I'll think about that in a moment. Have that horizon line, we're gonna have the water. I've done this scene before. We're gonna have a little bit of water here, and we'll just have fun with it. Okay, so wet paper. What's up, Bill? How's it going? I'm on my friend Bill's property. This is his house. He lives here. It's so windy that any audio is barely even going to show up. But I'm just taking a little video of the paintings that I've been doing.
Okay.
I don't know if you saw the other ones that I had done of this view last weekend. The videos?
Not the videos.
Okay. So, how's everything going?
Good.
Good. What y'all got going on today?
Oh, Nikki's brother and his wife and their sister or something, and my mom's all came over.
Oh, very cool.
So, little hamburger, bacon, rice, and gravy.
Oh, nice. Yeah, Shelby made a sausage rice and gravy last night. Really good. More blue sky over here. And I was at my other friend's place earlier. Maybe it's some ultramarine blue. I'm gonna wash that in to some of these spots. It's kind of giving the illusion of the clouds and blue sky. So, with that. That's the main thing with watercolors, is knowing how the there's a degree shift in the drying that takes place. But then, what I'm going to do, and what I've been doing, I've been taking, this is my burnt umber mixture from earlier, mix it in with the ultramarine blue, get a gray, and I could use other grays. I have a volcano gray right here.
Okay.
I can mix that with the burnt sienna fur gray. And for like around the clouds, but that, and while it's still wet, it'll kind of still diffuse. You see the other stuff moving a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
Put that in. That kind of added texture. So I'm not doing the sky verbatim, like, it's really true to the way it is, but just kind of getting a concept in there. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Then just to show you. Payne's gray dries a lot lighter too. See how it's a little bit darker, different types of gray?
Yeah.
So there's different types of gray that you can mix or have on your palette. There's this one woman that has her own gray that she like developed, mm-hmm. and one of the brands started carrying it and mixing it for her and all that. Yeah, because she's like a big colorist and whatnot. But so just kind of putting things in, and if I want to lighten stuff up, I could take it.
Just dab it out.
And there's a famous watercolorist from England in the early 1800s that developed a lot of these techniques. Like pretty much any technique used today was developed by him, or used by him at least. And he would take stale bread and use stale bread to dab out stuff, which was pretty crazy. But you see how light it's drying?
Yeah.
So kind of putting a little bit more in. But that's the good thing about going outdoors and painting, is that you can kind of do it from life. A photo's a lot different.
And then the wind helps dry it fast.
Oh yeah, without a doubt. Because I use the blow dryer home. So I'm going to take some more of that ultramarine. Mm-hmm. Just feed in some interesting spots of it. It's kind of impressionistic. We'll see. Mm-hmm. It kind of hit, kind of didn't. Maybe it wasn't necessary. But, you know, it's just getting ideas out there.
That's so cool. I mean, it's...
So, I don't know if that's a good sky or not. Interesting. It's different than what I normally do.
Yeah.
But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, and then I have a different blue on my palette. A phthalo blue, mm-hmm. which is like, call it like a mentholated blue. You know, if you have like Vicks Vapor Rub. Mm-hmm. And I mixed my green with that, the raw and that, and I'm just going to come in the background. So that's going to be the grass line in the far distance.
Okay.
Then it comes along here. This is the water in front.
Okay.
So I'm going to dry brush a little over to get a little texture on either side.
Okay.
Carry this over. And I think I could do it with a light wash.
That's not light at all.
But if I want, I'm going to take this dirty wash, put this in here, and when it dries, I'll show you in a second if it dries.
Okay.
So now I'm going to do that far tree line. Okay. And with that, I take my light red and mix that with my ultramarine, and that creates a different type of gray. This is kind of a purplish gray.
See that?
And I could push it more towards the blue. And the concept is, with color mixing, is ultramarine will kind of give you, a blues will recede in the distance. Because even though those trees are green, we want to receive them as green, but we have to push it in that direction to help it go back more. So I can just kind of put in the concept, or I can fiddle with it, but I'm just going to put in the concept, right? And it'll dry a little bit lighter and it'll push it back. Now this, they call, what do they call that? Cauliflowering, when a kind of water catches into the other area,
mm-hmm.
which happens, I think people try to avoid that. Anyway, I even have it happen in here. Oh my God, this is just all over the place. But, yeah, maybe it'll make it interesting. We'll see, mm-hmm. after everything's put in.
Oh, cool.
But. Anyway, so I put that in. Now I'm going to take burnt umber, burnt sienna, mix that with the ultramarine, so I get a different type of brown or gray. So, I'm going to use that kind of as my mud line. Yeah.
Gotcha.
So that's coming through there. Then, okay, so you see all the grass kind of in the, that's a crawfish pond, right?
Yep.
So this is dry. I'm going to take Payne's Gray, Raw Sienna, Ultramarine. I'm not really even going to mix them. I just kind of got them on there. And when you do something darker, in general, will give it the effect of coming closer to you.
Okay.
So this is quite dark, but this is
some grass in there.
Put some grass in there, right? And that's coming over. This is giving us the concept of it coming closer. Okay. Now, I'm just gonna omit those houses back there.
Yeah, those are just barns.
Yeah.
These old sheds to store crap in.
What I was gonna do, I was talking about how I was either gonna leave the space empty and kinda color them in slightly at the end, or I can use a piece of credit card to scrape out the shape.
Okay.
But I'm gonna leave that out. Now I'm just gonna do those trees. So with that, I kinda need a thicker mixture to help separate the background from the trees. Mm-hmm. So I'm using that same green that I used for the grass, which I'm probably going to come over the grass again with that rough sienna. But getting a green going, I can mix, get a darker, change the tone by doing that. And with this brush, this is a hake brush. It's a Japanese brush. Mm-hmm. And with this, and what I was trying to do over here, still wet, quite wet. Kind of
the tops of the trees.
Yes, exactly. And you, no fuss, and you put the trees in there like that. So there's a lot more trees, but I'm not really looking at them right now. I'm trying to just put in the concept, just talking through it. Then with trees, you kind of have a general formula or idea, especially distant one. If I have a green on that, the far shadow side, which is the bottom right on these, mm-hmm. will be darker or blue. So I'll put that in there. One thing that I have trouble with this brush is that I repeat a pattern. So you see a pattern getting repeated. Mm-hmm. Then...
You're not supposed to.
Well, you can. But I don't know. I find it not really aesthetically pleasing. And that cloud just has a whole bunch of muck with the water backwash. So with this style, you take a rigger brush, and they call it a rigger brush because it was used to paint the riggings on sails.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So if you're painting ships, which was very big, I think, what, the Dutch tradition? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're used...
So now you're doing the limbs.
Yeah. And now, there's an interesting thing that can happen here. This paint is still wet, and then I have dry paint alongside it. Mm-hmm. Dry area. So, I have a mixture of textures taking place. Mm-hmm. Where it's straight and nice, and then other areas, it's blending melting into the other, washing into the other. So just putting the concept in there. You can take this brush and go sideways and do an interesting side texture with it too. If you want. And I'm gonna have to get you a piece of paper and get you to start painting.
I have no artistic ability. I'm watching it going, well, this just looks like color slapped on, but when you finish, it's like, holy shit.
I know. And, I mean, you could take things and you can start scraping shapes into it. This brush, here, before I do the next part, underneath the trees, you see how it's the shadow underneath?
Mm-hmm.
So, just gonna stop. And I had this exact same issue earlier in the previous painting I did, where I didn't have the color immediately that I wanted. So that's just the shadow underneath the trees. And then, to make that pop, I'm gonna take this, the raw sienna, texture that over that. Get that dead grass coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And now I have like strokes over strokes and I'm getting a texture taking place. If we want, texture of the water. Look at that.
Yeah.
See that texture taking place? Mm-hmm. And to show you scraping, because like sometimes whenever I'm doing a video or testing out paper, so I've been trying different brands, I'll just use these techniques even if I didn't want to use it in it, just to see how it holds up. And cotton paper is great. It really holds up to the scraping really well. Now, paint-wise, that's a failure right there.
Okay.
I think, personally. Just looking to see what else can take place.
Wait, my company's outside. Let me go.
Oh, okay. All right.
Visit with them. I'll see you in a little bit.
All right, I'll see you in a bit. I'll probably be in a different spot on your yard. So that was Mr. Bill. He's a great guy. Just going to take that rigger brush, add some texture in the front. Make it interesting. Come back in over those dry trees. Get some more branch structure. I have some trees that just rise up. This one's really impressionistic. Take a little lemon yellow at the end. I'll let a little bit into the top of the trees. I think this one's almost done. Kind of trailed off with narrating this one, I apologize. Let's just add some birds for interest. You know, there's just so much going on. Add some more grass in the crawfish pond. Let's call it at that. All right, hopefully you enjoyed.